little different because I'm recording on my laptop again instead of actual, like, the handheld cameras. But I wanted to come to you guys with a quick braid out and an undercut update. So let's go ahead and just jump into this video. Okay, y'all, so I just got out the shower and I want to take my hair down. I washed my hair. Today is Monday. I washed my hair on Sunday. I did not retwist it, as you can tell. I just braided it, and this is the results. I went to work like this and had a hat on my head and kept it simple. Kept it simple. And obviously it's chunky braids because my hair is pretty thick. So I did actually only use three strands or three locks when I braided it, which might have taken a longer time. But this is the front, the side, the other side, the back, and I'll give you guys like a little undercut preview. This is my undercut. Okay, so let's go ahead and get into the video of me taking down these braids. So I used my Talia Wajid healing oil. I'm going to use that to take down my hair. First, let me just take all the rubber bands off. So, yeah. I feel like I haven't made a hair video in forever. So, I said, let me just come on here and make a quick hair update. Show you guys how my hair is doing. And one of my subscribers had also asked about my undercut. Now, I recently got my undercut recut, and I had got it styled, or got a design in it as well. That was probably about a month ago. I don't know if you can tell from when I just showed it to you guys how much it's actually grown in, but it's still pretty low cut, but yeah, it's starting to grow in. I usually just get it. For the most part, I don't cut it just to have a fade. I always cut it to have a design or a style in it. So every time when I do get a cut, I have to wait a while because I have to wait for it to have, the undercut to have enough hair for it to actually go through another style where it can be designed and cut to be cute. I was actually thinking about trying the next time when I do get my undercut cut. I was thinking about trying just having it a plain fade. Nothing special, no design or any of that. Just a regular haircut in the back. Just to see how that would look. I know, I don't know if you guys have been following my channel for a while, but when I initially got my undercut, I cut the two back rows of my locks. And I dyed my hair blonde, like a honey blonde color. So it looked really nice when, it made it look more vibrant once I went to the barber and got my hair cut. And thumbs up this video, y'all, if y'all have gotten some type of razor blades to y'all head and it make you feel extra sensitive. Because, like, I feel like every time when I go to the barber and get my hair, like, get it cut in the back, y'all, I feel like I'd be so, like, extra precautious. Like, I cannot move any type of muscles at all when I'm getting that razor to my head. It's like, I don't know how guys really get intricate hair designs throughout their whole entire head if they have to have the razor go through their entire, It's not for your girl. It's not for your girl. It's too much friction. It's a lot. And I don't feel comfortable with it. It's like you have to stay still. And I already be feeling like my skin is already so sensitive. So I don't like pushing it to the limit. Because the first time I actually got it cut, the barber had used, I went to my boyfriend's barber. And he had used some clippers, I guess, that were too rough for my scalp, or too rough for my skin. So my skin ended up turning a little bit red, and it was a mess, y'all. Like, I had to put a whole lot of shea butter on it every single day and stuff like that. It was just annoying because my skin was irritated. It started to like scab up and stuff like that. Like it was the worst. But from that point, I always know to tell whoever I'm going to that my skin is really sensitive and you can't be as rough on me because I'm delicate.
I'm a lady.
But yeah, yo, I'm taking these braids down so I can, I don't have to worry about doing it in the morning time. And also, it feels better when I don't sleep on these braids because sometimes it just be too tight to my scalp. I don't know about y'all. How do y'all feel when y'all have, braids in y'all hair and you sleep? Do y'all get good sleep? Let me know in the comments below. What's taking a long time is, I tend to not pop the rubber bands when I'm taking them out because I'll save them because the rubber bands usually, a container of black rubber bands usually lasts me for a while. So if I don't have to pop them, if they're not thin and worn out, I'll keep them and save them for the next time when I do a style to my hair. So this is my braid out. If y'all ain't know, braid out is always bae. Always bae. Because braid out always help you have some type of quick slay. But I'm not going to manipulate it too much because I am just going to be going to sleep. And I just took this out tonight, so it won't be too much tension on my scalp and saving time in the morning time when I'm getting ready for work. So this is the front, the side, the other side, the back. And I'll show you guys my undercut again. And just to remind you, I haven't had it cut for basically about a month.